Pupa for the goal. You don't want to remember stick measurements. Rangers down 2-1. Tamara says, what in the world's going on?
No, he's pointing at Hammerlock on the penalty box. That's who he's pointing at.
Lightning come right back, though. Patrick Poulin. Just the second of the year, we have a Patrick Poulin sighting. 3-1 Tampa. End of the second period, tempers flare.
Well, Jason Mazzotti's frustrated with the way he's playing. He did not play well in this game. He's going to take it out on Ulanov. The other end, Pupa Scoop is just watching it, shaking his head.
Tampa! They win again!
That's right, Tampa!
They had won or had lost. It's not a developing situation, but it's an update. Not a developing situation is we don't have a goal. Ted Donato could not come through, or else it would have been a developing situation. That's critical clarification information, as Donato unable to convert.
To start after Felix Potvin letting in that 400-footer the other night from Al McGinnis and played very well early. One of the best backups in hockey. He gives the team a chance to win, came in and played very well tonight.
Korolev's backhand attempt here goes in front. Sergei Bereszin beats Gar Snow. 2-0 Toronto in the second. Right here.
Right here. You're quick tonight, Billy. You're on the mark tonight.
You know, you're stopping short. That's the problem. You're supposed to be talking over these plays and you're not. We got a replay. What do we have?
Well, we got a replay. Comes around. And it's a goal.
8 minutes into the second now. It's Matt Sundin. 3-0 Toronto.
Well, this was a terrible play by Gar Snow. He mishandles the puck. Sundin was going to change. He smelled blood, came in, got a nice pass, put it in the open net. Good night for Matt Sundin.
Third period, Healy save on John Drews. On the loose, Daniel Lacroix has his helmet knocked off. Later on the third, Healy the save on Brendan Moore.
What do you have there?
Good night for Healy. Goaltender goes side to side, comes across, makes a save, and controls the rebound, which is paramount around the front of the net. Good night for Glenn Healy. Played very well.
And Toronto goes on to win by the final.
Sean Burke and the Hurricanes, 7-3-1 in their last 11 first period. Habs in the power play. They have the best road power play in the league. Brian Savage is fourth of the season, 1-0 Habs. Saiku Koivu thinks he has a goal. Sean Burke says you'll get nothing and like it. Alain Vigneault, a young Dan Aykroyd, stunned. Hurricanes capitalized. Jeff O'Neill beats Jocelyn Thibault, 5-hole. Hurricanes win 2-1. The Habs were shooting for their first six-game road win streak in 15 years. They're now 8-2 on the road. They remain in first place in the Northeast / Adams division. Ex-Whaler fans, attendance in Carolina, 6,896. Oilers and Stars, the Stars and Oilers meeting for the first time since their dramatic playoff series last spring. The O's won in 7. The Stars looking for retribution. Craig Ludwig, the hip check on Mike Greer.
Flop has become a very famous thing. It's a patented Hasek flop, and then again, you also have the patented Dominic Hasek all push over the net like you did during that game with Ottawa last year. Do you remember that?
Hasek tipped the net on purpose, and he got caught.
No, I don't remember.
It's funny how he doesn't remember that. All the stretching, it affects the memory. Could you do me a favor, though?
Okay, you want to push?
No, I don't want to push. I want you to help me up.
Oh, okay.
Help me out. Okay, we're going to lunch now. Last year, you win the Hart Trophy as the league's MVP. You are the first goalie to do it since Jacques Plante in 62, and the first Buffalo Sabre to ever do it. What did that mean to you?
It's something I'm very proud of, you know. But like I say, it's nice to win all these trophies. You know, I won Vezina's trophies. Back in Czech, I won the trophy as the best player of the Czech Republic. But nothing is nicer when you go together with the teammates, you know, when you win the game or you win. I never won the Stanley Cup, you know. To celebrate the win with all my teammates, with all the fans, is the best thing, you know. And that's what I am still missing here in the USA.
You're still striving for that experience of winning the Stanley Cup.
Mm-hmm, exactly.
We have wings here for you all.
Oh, look at that. Now, this is more like it.
Oh, look at this. Ah, buffalo wings.
Now, Dom, I think I'm going to like the mild ones because I don't think I can handle spicy buffalo wings. So which ones do you think I should try? Which ones are mild?
Well, I think these ones.
Are you sure?
Yeah, these are mild, very mild.
Very mild?
Yeah.
Positive? Right. Because I've heard about these wings. Do you know that they call these wings, they're hot wings here, they call them suicide wings?
I don't.
They're terrible.
These are for sure very mild.
Dominic! You're wrong! You're known as a very, very competitive guy, and that competitive nature of yours even transcends to practice sometimes, doesn't it?
Sometimes. Sometimes, you know. I just don't like if somebody scores against me, you know. And
doesn't matter who it is.
Doesn't really matter, you know. Especially if Rabre scores against me, I don't like it at all. Because he always makes fun if he scores.
One of us is going to eat lunch, and that's going to be him. I think I'll just stick to the celery so well. Dom finishes his lunch here. Why don't you check out this classic confrontation? Is that good, Dom?
You know what, Jennifer? Finish the conversation, and let's eat our lunch.
When the Florida Panthers signed Esa Tikkanen in the offseason, it probably had something to do with his performance against them last year in round one of the playoffs. Madison Square Garden was the setting for game three between the Rangers and the Panthers, and a bizarre overtime finish.
Leach with Flatley and Tikkanen 3-on-2. Tikkanen turns, he shoots high, hit the bar, hit the crossbar. Oh, a rising rocket that hit the bar.
Tikkanen thinks it was in, it wasn't in.
Or so everyone thought. The play would be reviewed.
Still no word. Still no word. Rangers win!
3 nights later, with Florida on the brink of elimination, Tikkanen was called for a penalty that would cost the Rangers. On the ensuing power play, Ray Shepard tied the game, forcing overtime, where Tikkanen would seek redemption.
Tikkanen shoots! Score! Score! Esa Tikkanen does it again!
Tikkanen's goal sealed the series for the Rangers, advancing them to the second round.
They move the puck around really well, but for the most part, what they've done is just shoot and throw it in front of the net, time after time after time. Cliff Ronning got a good shot on Kirk McLean. McLean had to cover up very quickly. Here's a good overhead shot. Oh, that's the shot by Tkachuk. That was a 2-on-1 from the blue line in, and it's really difficult to tell. I don't think in this third, Rick Tocchet will make a terrific pass out from behind the net. So JR, one-timer, he fans on it, and then here we go. Alexander Mogilny with great speed, his second breakaway. He goes for the layup. He misses second consecutive layup. Missed also by Mark Messier. Reminds me of the shoot-arounds in basketball. Looks like they were both going to the hoop. And Rick Tocchet wasn't too pleased about that missed chance by JR. He knows that he's got as good a hand as anybody. It just happens sometimes.
Oh, didn't happen, though. 102 into the second, Doug Bodger. Doug Bodger had only one goal the entire year last year. Got a goal here. It's 500th career NHL point, 1-0 San Jose.
Well, Doug Bodger has scored a lot of goals in his history. He has been an offensive player, but not lately. He jumps down the wall, stands up really well. And I don't think I've ever seen Doug Bodger shoot a puck any harder than that. Ronnie Hextall didn't play it extremely well, but a great goal by Bodger.
1:17 later, Dave Lowry acquired last week from Florida by San Jose. First goal of the season, 2-0 San Jose.
I like Dave Lowry. Always remember him for Florida, big player. He waits in the slot. Philadelphia is not good in their own end in this game or last game. Lowry gets his first goal. Great fight here. Potomsky, Barry Potomsky, Brant Myers, both young guys trying to stay with their team. And this, unfortunately, is how they have to do it for them.
9:30 to go in the second. Doug Bodger, second goal of the game. 3-0 Sharks. What's going on?
This might be the best game I've ever seen Doug Bodger play. Every big play he's in the middle of, he throws the net off Yanni Niemann's stick into the net. And another fight here. We got Lindros. Throws away the helmet, going with Todd Gill. Lindros was a marked man all night long. San Jose, as Toronto did last night, played him very hard. And there's Doug Bodger again.
We've seen him on offense, now we see him on defense.
Stands up really well, plays the body. As I said, this might be the best game he's ever played. He knows that he goes back and talks to Mike Vernon.
Now, toward the end, watch this.
Well, we got to fight Marty McSorley and Eric Lindros. I think Eric is just very, very frustrated. He appears to bite Marty. Know Marty like I know Marty, I wouldn't be biting Marty.
I tell you, it looked exactly like Tyson's bite of Holyfield, and you saw it freeze when his Penguins are all time against the Senators. Thomas Gronman with a goal, 1-0 Pittsburgh. Pence keep up the pressure. Stu Barnes uses his speed to break in, but Damien Rhodes there to make the save. More Penguins. Ed Olczyk dumps it in. Rhodes can't handle the rebound. Frederick Olsson bangs in the loose puck. Mick Magoo can see. No goal.
Good call, Mick. Mick's right on top of things. He drops the puck. Yes, it's right in front of him, but he's interfered with a Pittsburgh player. They come in and score, but it's a good call by Mick Magoo from Regina.
Where's that?
Saskatchewan.
All right. Magnus Arfvedson, the open end of the rebound. Barrasso makes the glove save. Watch it again.
Tommy Barrasso was very sharp tonight. Looked very, very strong in that for Pittsburgh.
Now Rob Brown. Creative kick pass to Barnes. What happened here?
Great play by Robbie Brown. You see how creative and imaginative he is. He throws it over to Barnes with his foot. Barnes, he blows the play, though.
Second period, Yanni Lahkonen has already injured his groin. He'll block the shot, go down in pain, left the game with a pulled groin, and did not return. Did not happen, though, on that play. Peter Ferraro and Chris Ferraro, identical twins. We don't know which one is which, but credit the goal to Chris Ferraro, 2-0 Pittsburgh.
Well, it was a good play. Hicks actually made the play right here. Freezes the goaltender, fakes a shot, puts it across to Ferraro, who makes a nice little move over the goaltender's stick.
Senators try to get the O going. Yashin skates in, takes a shot. Barrasso makes a save. Barrasso and Pittsburgh flanking the Senators by the score of 2-0. Barrasso, his third shutout of the season, the 26th of his career. Think he's got some ability, and he looked good there, but Tabarachi able to come up with a save. Off the faceoff, Zarly Zalapski gets the puck. Fleury, the rebound, passes Jim Dowd, 1-0 Calgary. Now, Florida's upset because John Van Beesbrook, did he have the puck in his glove? Well, referee Paul Stewart never blew his whistle.
So he never makes a bad call. That was the right call. Watch here, scramble right here.
They said the whistle did not blow. Doug McLean upset. We never heard the whistle blow. McLean's been suspended for going after the officials during this year, but not star right now, bothered by a bad shoulder, but he should be back in the lineup shortly.
Right there, you see the numbers. Those are four pretty good goals.
Eric Lindros, the player number one in the voting among wingers. Brendan Shanahan is second among wingers. He's been slowed at times by injury this year, but only trails the player by 2,000 votes or so in the voting.
Well, some big guys are
12-5 start. We'll go into more detail in a moment, but Edmonton's top players have been awful. Jason Arnott, a minus 15. Ryan Smith, a minus 15. Andrei Kovalenko, 0 goals in 19 games. The Oilers at St. Louis. Ron Lowe looking for a turnaround. They haven't won since October 29th.
Right off the bat, we've got a lot of action. Jason York's going at Muranov. They've been aggressive all night long. Edmonton really wanted to win this game. You could tell they're a desperate hockey club. In front of the net, you want to see action. Watch in front of the net. This is the pit area. This is where all the dirty, mean, rotten stuff happens. And it was like this all night long. High stick there. York takes it across the side of the head. Being a good player, it doesn't bother him. Goes back to front of the net. We see a little bit more action as the whistle ends.
Late in the first period now. Dean McAmmon, great move on Rudy Pocheck, feeds Andrei Kovalenko. Will he finally get a goal? No! Big night for Cujo, the former Blue. Big save on the one-timer by Brett Hull. And he stones Pavel Dimitrov's turnaround all alone in front. Late second, we're still scoreless. Todd Marchand splits the D, and he has got some ability. Watch this. Oh, what a goal. 1-0 Oilers.
Well, he's got lots of ability. He's got lots of speed also, Bill, and that's what makes this play happen. He jumps through the D. Grand Furious are going to come out and try and smother it. Catches him in between. Great play by Marchand, who's been struggling also.
More physical stuff now in the third.
A lot of physical stuff. Tony Twist right there. He's got his sweater pulled over his head. Takes about two Edmonton Oilers to handle Tony Twist. Now it takes two referees to handle Tony Twist. Look at those arms there, folks. How'd you like those wrapped around your neck?
Tattoo as well. Who's attacked down 2-0? Brett Hull, Jeff Court all across the goal line. Oh, hit the post. Late third, Oilers up 2-0. Doug Waite into the empty net. Says to Cujo, I know you wanted to beat your former team, and you did. In fact, it was a shutout. John Sweeney into the boards, goes head first into the boards.
Somebody went into the board.
He'll get four stitches, but returned right away. He's a hockey player. Pekka tries to wrap around. Byron Defoe stops it, makes a great save on the rebound shot by Jason Dawe. Watch it again. Defoe makes the glove save look awfully easy. Tough game for the rookie, Joe Thornton. Thornton is sandwiched by Bob Bubner and Curtis Brown. Welcome to the National Hockey League. Thornton ends up with a fat lip from the hits. Second period, still the which way did he go? 1-0 Sabres. Grosek gets a loose puck. Wayne Primo, second goal of the year. Sabres up by 2 goals at this point. Early third, Sergei Samsonov comes in on the break. Hasek stones him. Dominic playing one of his better games in a while. As he gets the shutout, Buffalo wins it 5-0. Sabres snapping a 5-game winless streak. They've won 6 straight over Boston in games because of a bad knee, but he's back. Ian LaPerriere. Whoa, he blasted it in there past Hackett, 3-1 Kings. Early second period, Tony Amate steals the Gary Galley pass. Length of the ice, and it's a shorthanded goal, 3-2. Later in the third, Rob Blake, not injured yet, still playing.
Kings up 4-2, and then some rough stuff late, Barry.
Well, we got a little frustration showing Chelios and Gary Galley, two feisty little defensemen. Not really little, not really big, but frustration showing on Chelios' side.
LA wins at 4-3. Blackhawks lose their fifth one-goal game of the season. Stumpel, one assist for the Kings.
Well, look at these numbers last
night off. First period, 1-0 Isles. John McClain, the wraparound on Fischel. But Fischel makes a save and covers. Now our...
We got our new, the big guy in the NHL, the tallest player, Sedano Charo, 6'9". Very impressive tonight. He shows that he's got guts. He's willing to mix it up. Made a lot of good plays, and he looks like he's here to stay.
What would a highlight be without mentioning Randy McKay and Bobby Holík? McKay puts a rebound off Holík skating in. Holík gets the goal, 1-1.
Well, you're seeing why this line is successful. Puck goes to the net. They're on the power play. Randy McKay shrugs off a check. Holík shrugs off a check, throws the net, and it goes in. Too big and strong to handle down low.
So that was Holik's ninth goal. Believe it or not, he scored more than Doug Gilmour. But Gilmour puts in the rebound here. That's his sixth goal of the year, 2-1 New Jersey.
Well, everything went well for the Islanders. They got off to an early lead, but they couldn't handle it right here. Gilmour tries to go across to his buddy, but it hits Kenny Johnson's foot and goes in.
Later in the second, Support carries a puck, goes in front. Fischel makes a great save and covers up. Another guy that's really helped them, we just saw him there, Support. In the third period, Scott Niedermeyer behind the net. Sakura's ninth goal of the year. What's happening here? Devils up 3-1.
Well, what's happening is we got our favorite player, Sedano Charo, going with another one of my favorite players, Randy McKay. Randy isn't happy with his treatment. He goes after the big guy. And I think the big guy got Randy a little bit by surprise there as he puts him down. And there's Randy's new baby. Drinks just like dad.
Eric Fischel, the diving save on Odeline, but Peterson puts the rebound in, and Fischel has some significant frustration issues.
Bad moves.
Devils win it 5-1. They've won 8 in a row. That's a new team record. Brodeur, 27 saves, winning his, throws it in front. Brad Isbister, fifth goal of the year, 1-0 Phoenix.
Well, Isbister scored a beautiful goal last game for Phoenix. Just throw it to the net. He's a big kid. He goes to the net. He knows that you're going to get rewarded going to the net. Throws the puck back against the flow, hits McClain and goes in.
Alexander McGillney starting to play some hockey. The move around John Slaney, but the shot is blocked. But later on, the Canucks shorthanded, and McGillney, when he gets this kind of separation, you're not going to catch him. 301st NHL goal, fourth of the year. Ties it at 1. Some emotion from Mike Tiedemann. Now, the shot from Lonnie Bohannes deflects off John Slaney's stick and in, his first of the year. 2-1, Vancouver, second period. Mark Messier to Dana Murzon, and Murzon in the slot, one time and a bang, 3-1, Vancouver.
Going to see a nice goal scored here. Jyrki Luun makes a great play with his foot, keeps it in right there. Sillinger gets it, nice backhand move, and he's just got a new baby also.
They pulled Javi Bulin after that. Now Lume, however, the turnover, bad pass, cross ice. Dallas Drake got a goal, still 4-2 though. Third period, Phoenix the extra man, under 1:30 to go.
And then we go to the game. Ledger dumps it in, misplayed by Bruce Driver. Dave Skatcher, Mister, and a goal. His fourth of the year, 1-0 Vancouver, he's a rookie. Rangers into the power play, Jeff Finley to Gretzky. McClain makes the save on LaFontaine. Now Mike Keane breakaway. Spectacular move here by Keane, but McClain says, Second period, still 1-0 Vancouver. They're on the power play. Lumi the shot, stopped by Richter, and then Messier is denied on the rebound. Sloppy, lackluster play, actually, in the first couple of periods here. Richter again denies Messier, and then stops Burry. 3-on-2 for New York, Messier back. And Barry breaks up the play.
Well, that was a great play, one of the turning points. Still close at that time, a 3-on-2. We almost had a strap here, but I think Stock realized that he better not fight with that guy. He's a mountain of a man.
And you knew Messier would get involved here. He got it from Lume. Textbook goal for him. 2-0 Vancouver.
Well, Mark dominated and draws all night long power play on Tenlikin. He won the draw, actually, to start this play in his own zone. And right here, defensive lap by the Rangers. Mess goes down the right side, gets a great pass. Patton move off his wrong foot, catches Mike Richter between the legs. I think Mike thought he was going to go far side. Lumi makes a great pass, cross ice. Now you see Messier. Richter, I think, thought he was going far side right between the legs. But Cinderella story, unbelievable night for Mets.
Gretzky says, yeah, I think he can do some things.
I've seen it before.
End of the second now. Messier's pass on the 2-on-1. He's broken up by Alexander Karpatsev. So still 2-0 Vancouver at this point. Third period, Sweeney, good chance, hits the post, Barry.
Right down low, and you're going to see Ness come in again. He had the puck a lot here. Goes into the middle, quick wrist shot, gets a rebound, doesn't put it in.
Rangers finally get on the board. LaFontaine, the power play goal. He's had a spectacular early season. 13th of the year, leads the team in that category. Rangers still down 2-1.
Power play has been very good for the Rangers of late. LaFontaine, with all this firepower, it's just a matter of time before they finally get one, but it was a pretty play.
Deep play of the game. About halfway through the third, Rangers with a power play, down one, and Dore goes back the other way. Short-handed goal makes it 3-1, Vancouver. Mike Keenan says, boy, that was a big goal.
Is that what he said?
I think that's what he said. We'll find out in a second. Vancouver goes on.
Barrasso, Reggett still hurt. Mironov with a shot. Scooter can't cover up. Solani, 24th goal of the year. That leads the NHL 1-0 Ducks. Now Slager, watch him skate in, fake. Twister and a goal. Ties the game at one. Moments later, Pitt looking for more. Two Barnes right on net, but Guy Hebert able to make the skate save, and we're still tied at one. Still in the first. Andreas Johansson breaks in, puts on a fake, beats Hebert far side, 2-1 Penguins. Then things get physical. Chris Ferraro cross-checks Jason Marshall head first into the boards. Immediate retaliation as Jeremy Stevenson takes on Chris Tamer at OC Doe, and down they go. More rough stuff as John Pronger and Kasparaitis get into it. Pronger came away the bloodier of the two. Pierre Paget with Paul Kariya. Second period, Ron Francis drops it for Jágr. This is Jágr being Jágr. Big time ability with the stick. 3-1 Pittsburgh. Paget with Paul Kariya. Moments later, Alexei Morozov puts a shot on net. Ron Francis gets his stick on the rebound. Trickles in, 4-1 Pittsburgh. Moments later, with Paul Kariya. Morozov shoots. And Solani to Sandstrom, who breaks in, ducks down 4-2. Solani, the quick wrist to Scooter, nice save, and a breakus breaks out in front. That's a massive breakus. Midway through the third, Ron Francis, the drop pass to Jágr. Oh, another great move for him. His second goal of the game, 5-2 Pittsburgh in the salute. Watch this again. Jágr doing some great things in this one. Late in the third, Scooter in the pinch down. It's a 5-on-3 for the Ducks. Solani tries to go short side. Kudrow with the sprawling save, and he gets his first NHL win. Welcome to the National Hockey League. Pittsburgh with Green. Travis Greener breaks in. Jimmy Wait, kick save. Paul Cruz, good first period for him. Absolutely crushing Michel Petit in the corner. And then with a scoring chance, he comes around the net, tries a backhand, but hits the post. Late in the first, more Islanders. As Nemchinov brings it in, he feeds Ziggy Palfy, but wait! In there for Hobby Bullen, makes a nice save. 3 minutes to go, Isles get on the board. Berard's pass will tip off a skate. Claude Lapointe buries a loose puck. His sixth goal of the year. Isles up one zip after one. Second period, Tommy Salo, thirsty and focused. Teppo Newman in the blast. Goes wide to keep Tkachuk. Robbed by Salo. Tkachuk cannot believe this. And you'll see why. Watch the replay. Salo reaches back. That looked like a surefire goal, but Salo said, uh-uh. Later in the second now, Todd Bertuzzi beats Newman. Newman, perhaps Phoenix's best defenseman, beaten there. 2-0 Isles. More Isles now. Watch Robert Reichel. 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, 4-1000, 5-1000, 6-1000. 7 seconds to do something, then he sneaks it past Waite. Jimmy Waite distracted by Brian McCabe coming in. Watch Waite get distracted right there, and Reichel made him pay. Third period, Isles shorthanded, doesn't matter. McIver breaks in. Berard gets back to knock the puck away. Tommy Salo stayed sharp. McIver brings it in, fires a shot, but Salo is there to glove it. On the replay, Salo able to make the save, even though Bob Corkum is in the crease distracting him, and it really didn't matter. Later in the third now, Palfy picks it up. Here comes Ziggy. Ziggy zagging. Got a goal. His 15th of the year, and the Isles win it by the score of 4-0. Salo's second shutout this season. Seventh of his career. He made 22 saves. Reichel, one goal. Looks for Ted Donato, then gets his own tip for the goal. 1-0 Boston. Later in the first, Jason Allison beats Curtis Lecision, then slips it past Trevor Kidd, who got the start. Sean Burke did not get the call on this one. 2-0 Boston. Second period, scoring out 2-1. Allison fakes a shot, passes to Hines. It's a slap shot and a goal. 3-1 Bruins. And then third period, Allison pushes the puck into the slot. Hines the hat trick, and Boston goes on to beat Carolina by the score of 4-1. Hines, for him, his third career hat trick, his first since returning
from injury on November 25th. Since that time, he's got 5 goals in his last 5 games. Allison, 1 goal, 3 assists. And Hasek, first period, going against a power play, makes 2 big stops on Alexander Daig. Later in the first, Hasek, another save on Daig, and then Hasek throws the puck up the ice. Then Ottawa back on the power play. Hasek makes the initial save, but Daig scores on the rebound. Hasek had been perfect for almost 8 periods, but finally that's broken there. Shannon's shot fools Ron Tugnutt, but it hits the post. Watch it again. Puck actually hits both posts before Tugnutt falls on it. Ball on it. Second period, still 1-0. Ottawa's on the power play. Yashin cross-ice pass to Kravchuk. Sean McEachern jams it past Hasek. Goal or not? Let's watch the replay. Chris Phillips clearly in the crease. That's a no-no, but Richard Potier says he was pushed in. Count the goal. Ottawa up 2-0. Lindy Ruff doesn't like it. Ron Tugnutt, sharp for Ottawa. Sabres on the power play. Tugnutt makes the save on Zhitnik, and then he's able to pounce on the loose rebound. Then more Tugnutt as he makes 2 quick saves, 1-2 on Jason Dawg. Hasek trying to keep Buffalo in it. Daig rushing down the left wing. Hasek makes the save. It's 2-0 after 2. Back to Tugnutt now in the third. Jason Dawg in front. Mike Wilson trying to make it 2 goals in 2 games. Then Jason Dawg tries to find Audette, but the pass handcuffs him. Randy Cunningworth scores into the open net. And Ottawa blanks Buffalo 3-0, so turnabout is fair play. First period, Corey Schwab can't clear the puck. Bobby Hulick to Randy McKay misses the open net. Devils can't convert early. Still in the first, Dave Andrechuk to Doug Gilmore. Corey Schwab makes the save. More Schwab. Scott Niedermeyer the shot. Schwab the save. Then he makes the stop on Eliash. Hulick shot blocked by Corey Cross. And finally, after a crazy sequence, the puck is covered up. 23 saves in the first period for Schwab. Then Sheldon Surrey and Louis DeBrusque dropped the gloves. Both players would get 2 minutes for roughing. And then when they both came out of the box, I don't see no one away. They go again. This time, both players got 5 minute fighting penalties. Off the faceoff. Ulanoff to Roman Hamerlich. And Hamerlich beats Brodeur to make it 1-0 in favor of Tampa. Lightning then looking for more. Puck in front of the net. Cicerelli Stone by Brodeur. Lightning up 1-0 after one. Second period, same score. Guerin shot saved. Puck comes over to Schwab. Racine off of his own man, Norton, to tie the game at one. Brian Bradley to Brian Ralston. 2-1 Devils. Ralston's second of the year. Devils offense continues in the third. Devils power play. Niedermeyer's shot will be blocked by Hamerlich. Hulick, though, gets the rebound and scores. Hulick continues his great play. He's got 14 goals on the year, 3-1 New Jersey. Then Randy McKay passes to Ralston. Ralston's second of the game. And New Jersey goes on to beat Tampa by the final score of 4-2. So Tampa winless in its last 15 road games. 0-14-1. Zip Matt Sundin, a wraparound goal. Ties the game at 1. We're still in the first. McCauley gets a rebound and makes it 2-1 Toronto. Wendell Clark, long shot, got a goal. 3-1 Toronto. Second period, Mike Johnson, nice stick work. It's 4-1 Toronto. Desai out, Frederick Chabot in. Didn't matter. Third period, Barrison gets a pass, stick work. Great move for the goal, 5-1 Toronto. 5 straight goals by the Leafs by 5 different players. Sundin, McCauley, Clark, Johnson, and Barrison, and Toronto goes on to win by the final score of 7-2. Most goals for the Leafs since November the 9th, 1996. Sundin scored twice, Barrison scored twice, Johnson 1 goal, 1 assist. Third straight loss for the Kings, and they're 1-4-1 now in their last 6.
Really going at each other. And now Gregson skates back toward him again.
He just got another penalty. Barnaby just got it from the bench. Cascada.
It's Marshall and Buchberger now at the Dallas line. Buchy trying to throw the right, and Marshall nailed him. Put him down. Now he's pummeling him with right. And now Nolan comes in late, and here we go.
Off the post, Shanahan trying to up the goaltender and dead. He hit it off Tabarachi.
3-0 Buffalo. Bugner.
And they score!
Only one star, really, in this first period, in my mind, and that's Brodeur. on either team. Otherwise, fairly uneventful. Here comes Guerin right in. He scores!
Coming on quickly. Intercepted. Axelson dropping it back. Thorpe moving in. Thorpe shot. Scores! Good Thorpe!
Perhaps this is their third shift of the game. Hallbig steals the puck. Nice move! In on goal! Scores!
He doesn't play yet. He just picked it, he missed.
There was Palfy waiting patiently out to the line. He moved around the point. Failed to catch up to it. Now takes it away. Here's Solani working in. Scores! And it across to the star! Shatan scooping it up, and the Devils did it again.
First minute of play in Colorado. The Avs will lose the puck at center ice. Messier, a blind pass to Bure, who was benched for part of Thursday's game against San Jose. Gotta go.
Starting again in this one. First period, Brian Scrutland. Second goal of the year, second of two nights, 1-0 Rangers. Rangers leading a game for the first time in over 10 periods. Richter sharp early, makes a save on Koivu, and then he reaches back and gloves the loose puck. Canadians now on the power play. Shane Fortson, one-timer. Was it a goal or not to tie it at one? It's ruled a goal. Fortson's eighth goal this year on the power play. That's tied for the league lead. Vincent Danforth to Ryshinsky. And it's 2-1 in favor of Montreal. Watch this blast, one time and a bang for Martin Ryshinsky. Second period, more Canadians. Richter will make the first save, but Vladimir Malakhov bangs in the rebound, his sixth of the year. 3-1 Montreal, so the Rangers again down. They're down two goals. No help in front of Richter's net here. Malakhov able to come in unchallenged and make it a 3-1 game. Rangers trying to answer back. Mike Keane, the one-time Montreal captain, ties up his man, Strootland. Third goal in two games. Rangers down 3-2. Watch it again as Keane ties up Danforth and then lets Strootland get the puck for the goal. The Rangers for the second straight night trying to come back. Third period, they're down one. They're looking to tie. LaFontaine uses his speed, but Thibault makes the save and then he stops to rebound. Take a second look. Great glove save here by Thibault, so it's still 3-2 in favor of Montreal. Rangers don't keep up the pressure. Adam Graves, who's been slumping. Their turnaround shot gets past Thibault. So the Rangers come back to tie at three goals apiece. Now they're looking for the win. LaFontaine's in front. Hits the post, though. And Thibault able to clear it away as the Rangers, for the second straight game, able to come back and force a tie. Ends in a 3-3 deadlock. Calgary and St. Louis. It's Rick Tabarachi, a couple of beautiful saves there as he preserves the 3-3 tie. Calgary and St. Louis all tied up at 3 in the third. Now we go to the goal light because we have a goal, and it's in Colorado. The Canucks and Avs. Adam Dedmarsh, just out of the penalty box, comes in. Ninth goal of the year, and Colorado now leads Vancouver. It is 2-1 right now.
For Sidor to move to the middle. Modano has it top of the circle. Sends it back Sidor. Sidor back to Modano. Has to play it off his skate. Now they send it deep. Neuendijk, cross-ice pass. They get it to Modano. Winds up. Now he lets it go. And a pass in. Made Brodeur. Sidor to Modano again. Offside pass. Here's a 10. Brodeur the save again. Out of the box. A pen down ball. It's a one-man advantage. Down for Dallas. Modano out near the line. Here is Sidor. Redirected and a save by Martin Brodeur.
There are two great things that happened in the last 30 or 50 seconds, and that is great puck movement by the Dallas Stars and better goaltending by Martin Brodeur. A lot of confidence with the puck the Stars have. Good movement there. Sidor's final shot went off a stick earlier, and then the position of Brodeur, he takes it right in the chest. Just before that, this is the best one right here, because Mike Modano half gave it a little bit of fake just to get Stevens to commit a little bit, and then he got an excellent shot on Brodeur, another excellent shot from the short side from Zubov, and a couple of great saves from Martin Brodeur. Then Niedermeyer before that, just a great defensive play using his foot speed. Now watch here. Dougie Gilmore is going to give him the handoff right here, right at the center of your screen. There it is. Hey, take my stick. There you go. Now it's better for your balance. Now he doesn't have to lean behind and lose sight of where the puck is. He's able to keep his balance. Oh, and it helped too.
Yeah,
he got the shaft of his stick along the ice. Now it's given back to him. The puck is cleared, and Brodeur reaches back calmly.
Eighth save of the night, Chicago's Jeff Hackett on Corey Stillman with a great effort there as he reaches behind and prevents the goal. But it's 1-0 Flames right now in the after the first period.
Thanks very much, Bill. Talking about keeping it straight, how about this one here? What a great save. That's a game saver right there. I mean, that's what can change momentum in a hockey game, is world-class saves like that from Martin Brodeur with that.
Take a look. Theo Fleury stepping it up lately for Calgary. Passes it along the boards. Andrew Castle scores with a big blast from the point, and it's 1-0 Flames. And Gary Suter tries to follow the Zamp. Jammed off rebound, flies over Tavarachi, but Suter will be fine. Hey, Barry, what's going on?
Well, Theo Fleury, one of my favorite players, going against another one of my favorite players, Chris Chelios. These guys have battled all night long. They're going into each other's faces all night long. Theo has a way of getting underneath your skin very badly.
Play the first two, 1-0. Watch Jeff Hackett. Robs Corey Stillman, Barry.
Puck goes side to side, hits a Calgary player. Now watch this. Hackett's been fantastic for Calgary. He's the main reason this team is winning consistently right now.
So it's 1-0 in favor of the Flames in the second period. Calgary posted. Ottawa and Carolina, Kirk McLean debuting for the Hurricanes. First period, McLean tested early. Igor Kravchuk the shot, but McLean able to make the save. Hurricanes now on the attack. Nelson Emerson steals a puck, takes a shot. Ron Tugnutt, though, says,
Nice little move here. Watch the crisscross. These are talented men making this play. Down to McEachran, good backhand shot, but McLean's there. Yashin gets a rebound, McLean's there again. That's why they got him.
Third period, Sammy Kapanen in the blast. His 16th of the year, that leads the Canes 1-0. And then Kapanen to Robert Kron, 2-0 Carolina. Martin Jelena, first game for Carolina, Barry.
That's how Martin scores. He goes to the net, he picks up a lot of rebounds, a lot of garbage goals like that. And right off the bat after that, Keith Primo, this guy's playing much better for Carolina right now. He gets a goal to make it 4-0.
And the Hurricanes go on to win 4-1. McLean winning his first game as a Hurricane. He made 22 saves. 13.
If you judge by Mike Keenan's past track record with goalies, Burke can count on playing a lot of minutes for Vancouver. Remember, when Keenan went to those Stanley Cup finals, he rode one big horse in goal, whether it was Hextall in Philadelphia, Belfour in Chicago, or Richter in New York. So Sean Burke going to get a lot of playing time in Vancouver. Some trades still to come in Vancouver, however. Trevor Linden could be the next guy out of town. Now, if some NHL general manager is looking to maybe make a steal in the trade market or even the free agent market, he might take note of Sergei Fedorov, that whole situation in Detroit. Told you last week, Fedorov basically telling people, I'm done in Detroit, looking for about $6 million a year. Yeah, that's high, but don't forget Eric Lindros and Paul Kariya, both coming in at over $8 million next year. Hey, and this guy Fedorov has Selke trophies, MVPs. He's about to hit his prime, and keep this other name in mind. He's on the shelf right now with a broken hand, but remember that Brett Hull is a free agent, no compensation the end of the year. If the St. Louis Blues lose contact with Colorado and Detroit, and now even Dallas, for top spot in that conference, and don't think they can make some kind of playoff run, look for the Blues to look around and place Hull somewhere. Be a situation similar to Wayne Gretzky when he was in St. Louis. They had to move him or lose him for nothing at the end of the year. And wouldn't this be curious? Two ways. Either Hull lands in Chicago, where his dad was a star with the Chicago Blackhawks for so many years, Bobby Hull with the Blackhawks. Or think about this. Didn't really work the first time around, but how about that finisher, Brett Hull, with Wayne Gretzky, not in St. Louis, but with the New York Rangers. In the corner.
Mike Madonna missed the last two games after coming back from the knee injury. Back in the lineup in this one. Doug Gilmore, the one-timer. His 10th of the year makes it 1-0 in favor of New Jersey. Comes on the power play. 2 minutes later, Gilmore, the steal, moves in, puts it in front. Dennis Peterson with a goal. 2-0 Devils on their first three shots on goal.
Great play by Gilmore. They're tipping it away. The defenseman doesn't take the body. Gilmore goes to the net, maybe gets a lucky bounce off Peterson. But slick play by a great centerman.
Now, second period, Lettinen and McDonald give and go. Lettinen, his 13th of the year, starts down 2-1.
There's magic between these two guys. Has been all year. Lettinen drops to McDonald. McDonald's got great vision. His speed backs the defenseman up. Great one-time shot by Lettinen. These two guys look great together.
35 seconds to go. Joe Neuendijk front. Cornell University missed the last seven games because of a bad knee. Back in the lineup. Ties the game at 3. And then 34 seconds into OT, It's going to be Lettinen with his second goal of the game, and Dallas, once down 3-1, comes back to win 4-3.
Same names here. McDonald drops it in the corner to Langenbrunner. Lettinen circling in the top. He finds a dead area in the defense, sneaks in there. Great pass by Langenbrunner, and McDonald winning goal. Great, great game.
Dallas wins it.
I would just go down, and I would kind of cover the bottom, and Andy would stand up, where now Eddie likes to go down. So if I go down, then it's kind of a waste.
He's still making saves. You know, that's been a big part of his game, and he just doesn't have to make quite as many saves.
With Eddie, I do try. There are certain situations where the puck's coming wide down the boards, and he likes to take those shots. I try to stay up more, but if there's any kind of scramble or mess around the net and there's a shot from the point, it's just a habit. It's a natural reaction for me.
That difference has most significantly affected the Stars' transition game.
It kind of stalls a little forecheck the team has. It helps our defense out, and it gets the puck up to our forwards quicker.
And you don't want to bump into McKenna. Wilson shaking up, but okay. Stefan Vissé, big save here on Curtis Brown. Then at the other end, Dominik Hasek will rob Yannick Perreault right there in front. Late in the first, no score. Mike Pekka skates in but cannot beat Vissé. It was zip-zip after one, and it remains scoreless in Los Angeles. Second period underway. Buffalo outshot LA 14-3 in the first period. Sabres unbeaten in the last three. We will keep you up to date. Hi, everybody. Great to have you with us on NHL Tonight. Along with Barry Melrose, I'm Bill Pito. He has had back-to-back 50-goal seasons, and now John LeClair is on pace for a 60-goal season. Reggie Leach has the all-time record for most goals by a Flyer in a season, 61 back in 1975-76. And LeClair's play hasn't suffered at all since Wayne Cashman decided to play Eric Lindros and LeClair on different lines. Barry, let's take a look now at LeClair and Groton together since December the 5th.
Well, I think this will be a turning point for the Flyers. They've been a much better club since he broke Lindros and LeClair up. You see the numbers, 12 goals, 4 goals. It's got Groton going. LeClair continued to go. Some nights, this guy's the best player in the world.
Flyers and Hurricanes. Canes goalie Kirk McLean aggravated a hammy, tying his skate in the locker room. That's a true story. So Trevor Kidd got the start for Carolina back from the finger injury. First period, no score. Canes on the breakout. Sammy Kapanen to Robert Kron, and Kron beats Ron Hextall, Barry, 1-0 Carolina.
Well, Kapanen's been the best player all year long for Carolina. He takes a hit, he throws it into Kron. Kron beats the defense, and with his speed, throws it upstairs. Nice goal.
Billy now on the power play. Paul Coffey to Yanni Ninema. Beats Kidd on the one-timer, third of the year. Ties the game at one. Paul Maurice wanted a high stick call, didn't get it. Second period, still 1-1. Another Flyers power play. John LeClair, big blast, stopped by Kidd. Then it's more Kidd. Eric Lindros can't beat Kidd on the one-timer. Watch this one again, Barry.
Well, again, it comes side to side. Now, you're going to see what a goalie sees, a one-timer through traffic. A lot of times, you got to be lucky and it hits you, but his defense does a good job after clearing the puck away.
Martin Jelena, former Canuck, to Jeff O'Neill. Hextall has trouble with it, but he's able to cover it up.
It's not a hard you shoot, Billy. It's your release. Great, quick release by O'Neill. Hits the post, comes back, hits the skate, and almost goes in. Ronnie's lucky he didn't knock it in with his stick.
Still 1-1. Carolina on the power play. Keith Primeau. His sixth straight game with a goal. 2-1 in favor of Carolina. But at the other end, here's LeClair. Great chance. And Trevor Kidd with a spectacular save. Barry, late in the second, now it's still 2-1.
This guy just is so strong. He shrugs off one check, he shrugs off another check, throws it in front. Chris Groton is the beneficiary of all that skill and strength and puts it in the net.
LeClair starting that play, early third period, still tied at 2. Tic-tac-toe, Nelson Emerson makes it 3-2 Carolina. But Philly answers less than a minute later. Groton, the long slapper, stopped by Kidd, but LeClair bangs in the rebound, ties the game at 3. Still tied at 3, Philly with a chance. But Rod Brind'Amour robbed by Kidd's glove save. In OT, the game tightens up. Keith Primeau tries to race in, but Eric Lindros says, uh-uh, no you don't. And the game ends in a 3-3 tie. Kidd, not supposed to start the game, played awfully well. He made 38 saves. Philly, 3-on-1 in its last 4. LeClair a goal and an assist. He's tied for the lead.
Almost won the game for them right there. So LeClair right now, again, is just super. And he doesn't need Lindros to be great. And Lindros doesn't need LeClair to be great. Now they got two good lines that are scoring consistently instead of one.
Philly's back in action on Friday night. You can catch the Flyers and the Caps right here on ESPN2 Friday night at 7 p.m. Eastern time. Elsewhere, Phoenix and Boston, first period no score. Sergei Samsonov and Jason Allison give and go. Allison fights off the D, puts it past Nikolai Hobby Bullen. 1-0 Boston. Second period, same score. Samsonov at mid-ice slips. Whoops, gets back up. Jukes not one, not two,
holy
but four
moly.
Coyotes. Finds Allison, and he beats Hobby Boone. And it's 2-0 Boston. Third period, 3-1 Bruins. Allison picks up the loose puck behind the net, goes around the net. And his first career hat trick as Boston wins it by the score of 5-2. Home game against Washington. As Colin Campbell says, right now, Cloutier is a young goalie playing behind one of the best goalies in the league. So Richter again starting. And even before the opening faceoff, Barry.
P.J. Stock just called up from Hartford again. He doesn't want to leave the Rangers. He likes it here going against Dale Hunter, one of the guys he wants to be like. They go at it right off the bat. Stock gets, both guys take a 10-minute misconduct, which gets Dale Hunter off the ice for 10 minutes. So right off the bat, Stock's doing a good job.
Caps here with a two-man advantage. Jeff Tom's a pass, but Richter able to make the save. Richter sharp early. Kelly Miller, the good shot, but Richter makes a save and then gloves the rebound. Peter Bondra and Adam Oates. Look out.
Good hit, Adam.
I warned him. Rangers get the offense going. Brian Leetch, the puck, takes a shot. His third goal in the last two games. 1-0 New York.
One of the reasons the Rangers have been winning is Adam Graves is playing better and Brian Leetch is playing better. This looks like vintage Leetch. Takes it on the fly, comes in, always had a good shot, finds a far post, and it goes in.
Now Hunter and Stock again.
Right off the battle, these two guys, obviously it's a thinking by the Rangers, get Hunter off his game instead of vice versa. Stock did a great job. Hunter ended up taking another minor for 12 minutes, so they kept him out of the game for 12 minutes, which is good for the Rangers. They look exactly alike.
Not good for the Rangers. Peter Bondra, 24th goal in the year, ties it at one. Second period now. Wayne Gretzky to Bruce Driver. And Driver, his fourth goal of the year, Rangers up 2-1. More New York now. Kevin Stevens will throw the puck in front. Nicholas Sundstrom, his ninth of the year, 3-1 New York. Late second period, though, Andre Nikolishin with a spectacular feed to Bondra. His second goal of the game brings it to a 3-2 game, caps down one.
Rangers had a good game plan, but they should have had Stock trying to get Bondra off the ice. Great play by Nikolishin here, play of the night. Great drop pass. Bondra knows what to do with it.
Third period, Oates the puck. Andrew Burnett ties it at three. And then Bondra, looking for the hat trick, has got himself a hat trick right there. So once down 3-1, the Caps come back to beat the Rangers 5-3. Bondra's first hat trick of the year. Two assists for Siggy Palfy, finds Brian McCabe. Ties the game up at one.
McCabe doesn't have a goal yet this year. It's nice to make a play like this on your first goal. Palfy makes the play. He draws everybody to him. Finds McCabe coming down the open side of the ice. And McCabe looks like he's got some skill here. Goes to his back on between the legs. I can't believe this guy's only got one goal now.
Later in the first, we're still tied. Mark Recchi to Shane Corson on a breakaway. And Corson hits the post. Later in the first, Montreal on the power play. Recchi's behind the net. Brings it out untouched and beats Tommy Salo. 2-1 Montreal. Where's the D?
Well, all you Islander fans, don't watch anymore because it gets pretty ugly after this point. Recchi goes to the front of the net, no one picks him up. Weak play by the goaltender, weak play by the defense, and it ends up in the net.
Second period, still 2-1. Habs have an extra skater on a delayed penalty. Dave Manson, a one-timer, deflected in by Brian Savage. And it's going to be 3-1 in favor of Montreal. At this point, Eric Fichaud would come in. It's the third time in his last four starts that Tommy Salo has been pulled. Goalie change wouldn't matter at all. Martin Rushinsky will center. Savage all alone in front. And it's going to be 4-1 in favor of Montreal.
Well, you're seeing here why the Islanders have lost 9 games in a row. Nobody's picking up men. Huda goes in the corner, takes his man. Johansson does a good job. Travis Green wants to be a goalie here. Doesn't pick up the man or stop the puck. They're in trouble.
Later in the second, Rushinsky, 100th career goal. 5-1 Canadians after two. Rick Bonus has got to be wondering about his job security right now. The Isles in a free fall. Third period, Vincent Danfus floats one ahead to Savage. Blows it by Fichaud. He's got the hat trick to Savage, 6-1 Montreal. Later in the third, it's Savage again. Patrice Brisebois to Savage. He's going to wind up and beat Tommy Salo. So a career-high 4 goals for Savage. He also had 2 assists. He gets a career-high 6 points in the game, and that also ties a Montreal road record for most points in a road game. 6 points for Savage, 8-2 is a final. 2 goals and assists for Rusinski.
Moog, which has really paid dividends. Moog has played very well. You saw him play tonight, but he's also made Jocelyn Thibault a much better goaltender, and that's helped everybody. But again, the size of the defense, Malakoff skates very well. He's about 6'4", he's got a big shot. This defense is huge, but it also skates very well. We mentioned Malakoff right there, moves the puck very quick. Davey Manson, known nicknamed as Charlie Manson for good reason, comes in. He skates very well. Quintel, big, strong physical defenseman. He skates very well. So they're not only huge, but they skate very well. Popovich, another big defenseman, 6'5", 220 pounds, moves the puck well, can jump into a play. So yes, they've got small forwards, but they're big and strong behind the blue line, guys that can move the puck. They got a good rookie in Brett Clark there. So good, quick, small, fast forwards, big, strong physical defense that moves the puck and skates very well.
Again, a lot of ice time for this Brent Sutter line. So far, Chicago in. Shanahan shot. Great save by Hackett. Mark that one on the VCR.
Here comes Chorsky. Breakaway for Tom Chorsky. Happy ball in the save.
Is Doug Waite. Waite along with Ryan Smith. Waite driving in front. He shoots and a save by Bessay. Cars are in. Reed a shot. That one hit Rhodes, I think, in the noggin. Bam, right off the cranium. Rhodes with one of the quicker craniums in the National Hockey League.
Whitney again looking up front. He delivers. They shoot and a save by Guillebert.
And a steal. Here's Pomanka shooting. Save. Couture rebound. Stopped by Driver on the goal line.
Boy, oh boy.
Now to Sack. He has the Avs goal. Back in front of Denmark. Great move. A shot. Oh, what a save. Unbelievable by Hockett. Running moves up. Shoots. Knocked down. Rebound. Save by Salo.
A catching. Cloud save. Howie. How to do. What a beauty.
It comes into the circle. Now to Stumble. Squaring around. And Balfour's got it.
Good hustle. Washburn, though, gets it to Whitney. Saved by Vernon.
Here they come again. A pass walking in. Quick shot. Great glove save by Mark Fitzpatrick.
Back pass to Compton. Shot deflected by Connor Walter. Stop. Rebound. Saved by Poulsen with a glove as he robbed Brian Leach. Brilliant save.
Oh, baby, is that a save.
McCarthy shoots it right in front. Oh! How did that stay out? But it did. Hackett. Larceny on Stillman.
Back to the games now. Vancouver had a brief surge when Mike Keenan became coach, but lately Iron Mike's crew has been playing like scrap iron. The Canucks have just one win in their last nine, and they're just 4 points away from being the worst team in the entire league. The defense is the worst in the entire league, and the high-priced offensive talent has generated just 3 goals or less in 9 straight games. The Canucks at Colorado. Mike Keenan and Tom Rennie, some analysis.
More like tin, Bill, not scrap iron. The last 16, they've been terrible, not scoring. They're playing terrible defense. First 8 games with Mike, they've been playing much better. Everyone thought they had to turn around, scored almost a goal and a half more a game. Under Tom Rennie, basically the same numbers as Mike Keenan. This team is much better than it's showing, and Michael's trying to get it out of them.
Mike has had some problems with Trevor Linden. He's criticizing Linden's effort the last couple of days. Big controversy in Vancouver. 36 seconds in, though, Linden finds Pavel Bure. 1-0 Vancouver.
Well, maybe this is a good sign for Vancouver. Trevor Linden makes a good play off the draw up to Pavel Bure. Pavel blasts a shot right through Patrick's legs. That doesn't happen very often, so this might be a good sign, Bill.
But we talked about the Canucks defense. Watch this. Sandis Ozolinch to Francois Leroux. Leroux's first goal of the year. 2-1 at this point.
Anytime one of the tough guys score a goal, we talk about it. Frankie Leroux goes to the net. He benefits from being on the end of a great play by Sandis Ozolinch, but he puts it upstairs. Pretty soft hands for a tough guy.
Still in the first, tied at 2. Watch this as the puck will bounce off Matthias Olin's right skate, then the left, then it goes in. When it's going bad on defense, it's going bad. Kamensky gets credit for the goal. It's 3-2 Colorado. 8:30 now into the second period. Vancouver's got a two-man advantage. Bure shoots while the save. Mark Messier, though. Messier picks up a loose rebound, ties the game at 3.
You're going to see great action in front. Ness is right there for the rebound. Sillinger gets drilled over Patrick Waugh, which helped things out considerably, but Ness gets the goal being in front of the net.
6 minutes left in the third. Messier, second goal of the game. Vancouver's up 4-3, but just 13 seconds to go in regulation. Adam Deadmarsh, who's been in the doghouse of late, that'll get him in the good graces of the coach. Crawford ties it at 4.
Terrible rebound by Sean Burke here. It's got to go to the side. It can't go out in front of the net. Adam Deadmarsh right on his forehand. Game is tied. Things look bleak for the Canucks.
Jeff Sanderson now in OT to Linden, who falling to the ice, can't sweep the puck in. Another tough break for the Canucks. They can't hold the late lead, and the game ends in a 4-4 tie. The Avs are unbeaten in the last 12 games against Vancouver at 9-0-3. A league-high 14th tie for Colorado. Messier, 2 goals. Bure, 1 goal, 1 assist. Valerie Kamensky for the Avs, 1 goal and 1 assist. Linden played well for the Canucks. He had 2 assists.
Coming up on NHL Tonight, a look ahead to Friday's showdown between Detroit and Dallas. Chris Osgood and the Wings trying to close a gap on the Stars. But first, we have tonight's question. We told you about this year's commissioner selections to the All-Star Game. So who were the first two players chosen as All-Star?
Show violence just to show some gratuitous violence. But I'm going to show you a good play here by Luke Robitaille. After that little scrum in the corner, goes after Dominic Hasek. Those two guys are yapping. Luke decides to give him a little cross-check, and all heck breaks loose. We got a lot of stuff after the whistle. But anytime, if you're playing Buffalo, you can get Dominic that makes a big deal here back on defense is Ludwig. He blocks more shots than 90% of the goaltenders in the NHL. Another guy who's playing very well is Matt Tkachuk. He's active defenseman. He skates very well. They're very good in front of the net. They're very physical in front of the net. They're very strong in front of the net. If there's a loose puck there, it's going to be moved, and there's a good chance you're going to be knocked on your butt. That's why Dallas is good in their own zone. That's why their defense is good, and that's why Hitch is smiling. Now, Detroit is very good in all those areas, too, but what makes them special, just like Colorado and Dallas, is who do you stop on this team? If you stop Yzerman, Shanahan, you've got a guy like Maltby. You got a guy like Doug Brown, who scores consistently, just got himself a new contract. You got a guy like Marty Lapointe, who's going to set records for his goals this year. You got a guy like Joey Kotzer, who looks like he's about 25 years old, instead of almost 35. Joey scoring consistently and still giving the tough presence on the blue line or on the wing for Detroit. And again, everybody on this team is scoring. This is why they're so tough. Maltby can play with Yzerman, or he can go down to the fourth line. This looks like Mario Lemieux, not Kirk Maltby. So that's what makes this team so tough. You just, who do you stop? They're both good defense. They're both strong in net. They've both got great defensemen.
For stitches. Sharks on a clear now. Benoit Hogue steals it at the blue line. Takes it back. Shoots. Kelly Rudy, though, makes a save. Rudy's 17 saves in the first period. Dallas, a power play late in the first. Darryl Sador shoots. Yuri Lehtinen redirects it past Rudy. 1-0 Stars after one. That's where it is when we pick it up in the second for Tony Granato. Granato with the goal, just his second point in the last 12 games. And Dallas and San Jose are now tied up at one in the second period. Rudy has won his last five starts over Dallas. That's one of the big reasons he's in there. He's 12-4-5 lifetime against the Stars. Sharks have won the last five games against Dallas. Hardable brings it up, beats Kevin Hotsonberry, one zip Isles.
Well, the goal is created, Bill, in the neutral zone on a turnover. Good body work by Smolinski. Now you get the transition game. Chikorsky's going wide. He's got good speed. And I think Hodgson loses himself in the net a little bit because there's a lot of room on that far side, but it does hit the post and go in.
Later in the second, Ziggy Palfy missed a wide-open net, and that's one of their problems, and not getting the puck in the net.
Well, what's killing them is players like Ziggy Palfy are getting chances, and he's not putting the puck in the net. Here's a guy that scored 40 goals last year. Wide-open net, he hits the post. That's got to go in.
Now Isles shorthanded. Nemchinov can't convert as Hodgson makes a save. Later in the third, Slava Kozlov to Igor Larionov, and Larionov beats Wade Flaherty in there again for the Isles. Second straight start for him. It's tied up at one. We go to OT. In the OT, the Isles have a good chance. Palfy picks up the loose puck. Skates in 2-on-1, shoots, but Hodgson able to make the save.
Shades of last game against Carolina. There's a bouncing puck. It hops over McCabe's stick. It looks like Shanahan's clear, but McCabe recovers, makes a good defensive play. No goal. Tie game.
It ends in a 1-1 tie. Three goals or less now against Boston. Jason Allison and Sergei Samsonov, and Brodeur makes a glove save.
Jason Arnott is here now, and you're going to see what this guy's going to add to this team. He's another big body. He's got a great shot, slap shot, wrist shot, doesn't go in there. He's also one of those guys that can go to the net, win physical battles among a team that does that great with Andrychuk, with McKay, players like that. But this is a talented man. He's going to score a lot of goals. He's going to win a lot of battles. Now, Olawa's in front of the net, has not got a goal this year, leading the NHL in fighting majors. Kicks it in, obviously, but it doesn't count. Now you're going to see what he's more used to. A great fight here with Baumgartner a little bit later. He cuts Baumgartner over the eye. You see tape on his hand. That is an automatic match penalty for tape on his hand when you create a cut. Olawa goes to the bench, and he's rejoicing.
Zip-zip game early in the third. Samsonov beats Brodeur with a backhander, 1-0 Boston. Devils trying to come back. Scott Niedermeyer to Doug Gilmore. Stopped by Defoe with Patrick Eliash. His 14th goal in the year that leads all rookies in terms of goal scoring, and the game ends in a 1-1 tie. So Boston 3-0-3 in its last six. Devils unbeaten in the last.
Gervais going at it. This was a very physical game, just like last night's game for Tampa Bay.
Minutes later, Jason Bunk Sr. shoots. Andy Moak saves, but Paul Eisenbart with a goal, Lightning down 2-1. Still in the first period. Danfoss ahead to Savage. Pass Derek Wilkinson. 3-1 Montreal. They scored another one 17 seconds after that. And then it's 4-1 Montreal. We're still in the first period.
Well, again, DeBrusk goes out to, he fights Rive. Rive was a busy man tonight going against two big Tampa Bay Lightning players.
Now Dave Manson fires from the point. Shane Corson puts in the rebound. So Montreal, five goals in the first period. They led it 5-1 after one. And they go on to win it 6-3. Vinny D'Ampus, a goal, four assists, two goals from Bureau. The Canadians have won four straight now on the road. Musser. Off the Hurricanes turnover. Frederick Olsen and Ron Francis got a goal. 1-0 Pittsburgh. Later in the first, Bates Battaglia beat the Isles in OT on Saturday. Shoots a puck at his own goal. Kidd sticks it as it stands. Second period, Jaromir Jagr to Kevin Hatcher, and Kidd makes a big save. Third period now, Canes down one zip. Stu Barnes, terrible turnover in his own zone. Robert Cron stopped by Barrasso. Keith Primo, though, bangs on the rebound to tie the game at one. Later in the third, Olsson here springs Jagr on the breakaway, and Kidd makes a spectacular save. 9 minutes now left in the third. Still tied at one. Jagr springs Francis, and here comes Francis. Top shelf, 2-1 Pittsburgh.
Beautiful goal. You see Jagr, or Francis' strength here. Puts it upstairs. 29 points in the last 25 games, plus 13.
Then Jagr would break through.
Here's Jagr behind the defense, cutting for the net on Kidd. He shoots and scores! And he smoked him like a bad cigar.
Stu Grimson.
Well, Stu went crazy at the end of the game. I don't know why. He went after Alex Hicks for some reason. This was the last shift of the game. A little scrap broke out as Chris Tamer comes in to tries to save Hicks's neck, which is very important in this situation because Stu looked very, very angry. He needs a little Prozac there, Stu. But obviously, Stu was mad at Hicks from something earlier in the game.
He smoked him like a bad cigar. Pittsburgh goes on to win by the score of 4-1. Two goals for French.
Astrid Riggett has come in and played well. But Brasso tonight shows you why he's playing so well. He's always been a great goaltender. He's got great physical gifts, his size, his movement. He stands tall. He's very patient in net. He does not do a lot of wasted motions. You see, when he's on top of his game, very hard to score against. But goaltending has been very solid for Pittsburgh. Continues to be. Now they got Brasso back. Things are looking better in their
first period. Valeri Zelepukhin will get the pass. He was involved in the deal with the Devils along with Bill Guerin. Grant Fuhr, though, comes up with a big save. Blues on the attack. Pavel Dimitra, the big blast. Pass Cujo. 1-0 Blues.
Well, Dimitra's been a good player for the Blues all year long. Been very consistent. Turnover, Edmonton player has to get that puck out of that zone there. Great pass here. Good quick slapper upstairs over a screen. Good play by St. Louis. And Pronger here has been playing very well. Watch this play. Smith beats him, but Pronger gets a stick on him, controls his hands, so Smith can't get anything on the shot. That's a very good defensive play.
Third period, Mike Greer will throw the puck on net off of Chris McAlpine's skate and in. Ties the game up at one.
Greer's missed some time for Edmonton this year, and they miss this big guy. He's good around the net. He can score. He's a physical player. You see what he adds, winning those battles around the goaltender there and puts it in.
Blues on the attack. Jeff Courtnall to Pierre Turgeon. Turgeon hit the post. Oilers power play. Dan McGillis, a slapper for the point. Beats Fuhr. That's a power play goal. And Edmonton wins it 2-1. So they've now won four in a row. Just the Oilers' second win in 20 games when trailing after two periods this season. Has 20 power plays. First period, no score. Duck shorthanded. Joe Sacco steals a puck and hits a crossbar. Still in the first, no score. Jeremy Stevenson and the Kings' Doug Smolik. An OC-do and down they go. Second period, no score. Mark Jansons beats Fisse through the five hole. Anaheim goes up by the score of 1-0. Now, Sacco is now centering between Correa and Solani. And he doesn't have much experience at center, but here he feeds Solani, and Solani will feed Correa. And the Ducks, with that goal, go up by the score of 2-0 in the second period. Paul Correa, his ninth goal. He's got 21 in a hearing for this hit Saturday on Edmonton's Tony Herkes. Herkes suffered a separated shoulder. As we go to on the fly, Herkes will be out
instead. These guys went at it for a couple minutes. No holding, no hugging, just going at it. Left and a right and a right and a left. Langdon rested for a while. Domi fought. Domi rested for a while. Langdon fought. Give and take, and a sign of respect at the end of the fight between these two warriors. Little pat in the head. Well, job well done. And the second best fight of the year, PJ Stock, who does not want to go back to the American League. Chris King, these two guys went at it. Two great fights in the first minute of play. Both teams are hungry. Both teams.